Hello my dear 12thies, as you have already viewed part 1 of Democratic Resurgence chapter, in which we have discussed about Jayaprakash Narayan and one more very important thinker. Now in that series we have one more thinker, Deendayal Upadhyay and Integral Humanism. Students, as teacher, I really feel that in your question paper, there can be any question like pictures of any of these three thinkers can be given in exam and you can be told to identify the name. Okay? So please, you need to take help of Google to just see these persons so that you may identify. Okay, I am not doing it for you because it really takes lots of time. So that's why I am guiding you. Okay, do this job. Just go and look at their pictures. Whosoever's new philosophy is inserted in your syllabus, I hope you will go for it. Okay, like Deendayal Upadhyay, just type, you will see. So that you may, it will be easy for you to identify in case such kind of question is being asked. So let's come to the topic now. So this is the time period 25th September 1916 to 11th February 1968. Integral Humanism was introduced by Deendayal or is associated with Deendayal Upadhyay. So it can even be asked in matching. Okay. So an Indian politician and thinker of right wing. Right wing means not left wing. Right? You know there are different ideologies. So he was inside of right wing. Hindutva ideology, you already know, very main ideology of BJP. So exposed by the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh, RSS. So he belonged to that. Leader of political party BJS means Bharatiya Jan Sangh, which later on became Bharatiya Janata Party. So he was forerunner of BJP. Started monthly publication Rashtradharma. You need to learn it in 1940s. So monthly publication, the name Rashtradharma was started by him in 1940s. He was the president of BJS means Bharatiya Jan Sangh from December 1947 to 1967 to 1968. Then contested Lok Sabha elections in 1963, but lost elections. So this is very important that he died under mysterious circumstances near Megleshwar Junction Railway Station in February 1968. And very important, and I think there will be question in your exams related to his death, because after 50 years of his death, means in 2018, that railway station was named as Deendayal Upadhyay Junction. Okay, he was died in February 1968. So in 2018, that railway station where he was died under mysterious conditions is declared as Deendayal Upadhyay Junction. So you should be aware of this because this is related to the updations. So I think you will be evaluated at this platform also. Okay. So now let's come to the philosophy. He was philosopher, socialist, economist and politician. So his philosophy presented by him is called Integral Humanism. Integral Humanism. Integrated. So indigenous socio-economic model, which he presented in Integral Humanism, that is indigenous socio-economic model, means which is related to our own specific conditions. And what does it mean? Human beings should be at the center of the development. It was a very important point of this philosophy that human beings should be always kept at the center of the development. Then aim of Integral Humanism to ensure dignified life, respectworthy, okay, for everyone by balancing the needs of individual and society. Means there should be ideal combination of means no individual should be ignored and society should also not be ignored. हम इतना ज्यादा individualism नहीं हो जाए कि society, it should be at the cost of societal values. And इतना ज्यादा society का नहीं हो जाए कि individual should be lost. Individuals की जो qualities हैं should not get a space to come out, right? So it, he was talking about that there should be such kind of balance. So it was aim of his this idea, integral humanism. He supported sustainable consumption of natural resources, means our natural resources should be consumed while taking care of future generations, environment, each and everything. That only then it can be sustainable. Okay, can be used for long. Then this philosophy enhances political, economic, social, democracy and freedom, means integrating all the good values, democratic values, freedom, and should be promoting diversity instead of ignoring, instead of letting any one section of society isolated or marginalized. No, so everyone should be considered and given weightage. So means democratic as well as humanistic values, good combination. Now this philosophy is based on three principles. Number one, primacy of whole, not parts, means as a society you are very very important, not just as an individual. So there should be ideal balance of it. Number two, supremacy of dharma. Because you know, Hindutva means all that culture which we carry, that's always important. Autonomy of society. Because here it is being said that we should not cross our limits in the name of individualism, that it should present very negative example for the society. Right? So he opposed both Western capitalism and Marxism. Means he was against Western capitalism and socialism. And understood that it is not good for India because these philosophies are totally based on materialism, materialistic aspect of our life. But he said it doesn't give spiritual development any importance, but it is very very important. Our spiritual internal development is very very important than materialistic development. Okay. So he gives spiritual development equal importance for complete development, because our development will always remain incomplete agar aap bahut sari luxurious cheeze khareed rahe hain, gadgets khareed rahe hain, but it will not give you satisfaction, right? So that kind of development, materialistic growth, is always incomplete without spiritual development. So of human beings, which is missing in both capitalism and socialism, because as I told you, because he thought capitalism and socialism both focus on materialistic development and totally missing, totally ignoring spiritual development. So basing his philosophy on the internal consciousness, pure human soul, which he called as chitti. Okay, हमारा जो चित, हमारी जो चेतना है, I should say, that's very very important. Most of time I say, we say ना, आपकी कॉन्शियस ने ये अलाउ किया. When we see corruption all around, हम सोचते हैं इनकी कॉन्शियस ही मर गई है क्या? Because we are focusing on this spiritual part, right? Then he also had a vision of classless. Class, you know, is economic classification. He said there should not be any class. Casteless, caste is social classification of people. So there should not be any caste. Conflict-free social system. When it will be? When there will be complete development of humanism, humans, spiritual as well as materialistic. But materialistic can't be more important than spiritual development. Can't be more like greed. Can't be more important than satisfaction, right? So integral humanism focuses on human values and balancing, it is balancing our individual and societal needs. Okay, बहुत सारी चीजें हमें इसलिए नहीं करनी चाहिए because it will give a bad, very bad impression, very bad, it will set a very bad example for the society. Right? I hope you understood. All the very best. बहुत सारा पढ़िए आप लोग. You really need to. In case of any confusion, any problem, comment to me. Okay? In comment box, I will definitely try to help you. Thank you so much. Please keep on watching, sharing, commenting and subscribing this channel. Thank you so much.